Hello, I'm Bob Marks, and this is Astrology Now. This is the program for people who want to learn about astrology. Today, we're going to talk about the planet Uranus, your Uranus. Everybody always asks astrologers to tell them about their sign. What signs do I get along with? What's going to happen to my sign tomorrow? Folks, there is a lot more to astrology than just those 12 sun signs. You have to look at all of the planets out there, all of the planets in the horoscope. And each planet has a sign position and something else called a house position. And then there's angles between the planets, the so-called aspects, and midpoints. You have to take all of these things into account. So today we're going to look at the planet Uranus, the planet of genius. Everybody is a genius somewhere in their lives. But the planet Uranus also shows where we can have upheavals, crazy sudden events happening to us. It's a very important position in the chart. Let's take a look at an example horoscope. The first horoscope is the horoscope of Bill Gates. Now, when the planet Uranus is in the first house the way he has it, well, Uranus is independent. It is inclined to do things that are unusual or out of the ordinary, and it has a very strong inclination for anything at all to do with electricity. Well, there it is, the high-tech planet in the first house. Here was somebody who you might say was fated to stir things up wherever he went. If you have Uranus in the first house, you practically live by your own laws. Now, Bill Gates' sun sign is Scorpio. And Scorpio is a sign that likes to be the boss. So here is somebody who just wouldn't be anybody else's employee. He dropped out of college in his senior year to start Microsoft, and basically he's giving orders to everybody else in the computer industry. But it's the Uranus that did it for him. Not only is Uranus in the first house, but it has a strong aspect, a 90-degree angle, a so-called square aspect with the sun. Now, if you look at the old books, the books that were written hundreds of years ago, they say that the 90-degree aspect brings disasters. Not always so. In the horoscopes of corporate leaders, people who are very dynamic, you'll see loads of squares. Squares are obstacles to be overcome, and they also give the dissatisfaction to move ahead. If you have too many so-called good aspects in the horoscope, you don't go anywhere because everything is just too smooth for you. Well, not so with Bill Gates. There is a slight tendency here to be accident prone. And that is something that he is going to have to watch throughout his life. But the fact that the sun is 90 degrees away from the planet Uranus, and the planet Uranus is in the first house, this makes him a Uranian person, somebody who deals with things that are new, unusual, far out, strange, peculiar. And Uranus is the planet that's always turning over the apple carts. It always has to upset things. And that's what Bill Gates has done his entire life. My name is Bob Marks, and this is Astrology Now. This is the program for people who want to learn about astrology. Hey, folks, if you have a copy of your own horoscope at home, take it out and follow along, because we're going to get to the house position of your Uranus eventually. What about the sign position of Uranus? People are always asking, well, what's the difference between a house and a sign? Well, the signs are like lines painted on the sky. The houses have to do with how the signs are arranged around you. You know, if you look above you, there's a sign. Now, every 2 hours, that sign changes because the Earth is turning. You see, the signs themselves don't change, but they change their position around us because of the Earth's rotation. The sign position of a planet shows basically how the planet is acting. The house position shows where it's acting in your life. Now, the planet Uranus stays in a sign for about 7 years. So basically, whole generations have the planet Uranus in the same sign. That's not as significant as the house that the planet Uranus is in. Let's take a look at the next horoscope. This is the horoscope of Beethoven. And where is the planet Uranus, the planet of genius? Right there in the first house, the house of personality. I mean, this was a man who, well, he lived at a time when everybody was always deferring to the nobility. he'd be playing the piano in the drawing room of some noble person that was giving a party, and some people would be talking instead of listening to him, and that would infuriate him. He'd stand up and look at them and say, "I won't play for pigs," and he'd walk out. And he got away with it. The planet Uranus in the first house, eccentric, different, loves to turn things upside down. There's a story that they tell about Beethoven that he was walking once in the garden of the emperor with Goethe, and they were talking, and here comes the emperor with the emperor of Austria with an entire party of people, and Goethe immediately steps off the path and takes off his hat. Beethoven walks right through the middle of them, and they make way for him. And Goethe said afterwards, "What were you doing?" And Beethoven said, "You got to keep these people in their place." Uranus in the first house, the iconoclast, the person who's always overturning the apple carts, the shocking person, but also the genius. If you have the planet Uranus in your first house, that gives you the power to really stir things up wherever you go. Now, sometimes we tend to repress a planet like that. And when we do, well, Uranus strikes back and makes all sorts of crazy, unexpected events happen in our lives. Let's take a look at the next horoscope. The next horoscope is the horoscope of the good old USA. Well, this is certainly a country that overturned apple carts. There is the planet Uranus right in the first house. Now, some astrologers disagree with this chart. They say that we have Sagittarius rising. That doesn't quite fit the country. We also have Mars in the first house. Mars and Uranus are co-rulers of firearms. Mars, the planet of violence. Uranus specifically, well, Mars rules swords more than anything else, but anything connected with violence. Uranus specifically rules firearms. And, well, this country is fanatic about owning guns. This country is fanatic also about, well, again, turning things upside down. If it's crazy, if it's new, if it's unusual, if it's far out, it's American. Uranus in the first house. The motto of the country should not be E Pluribus Unum. It should be new, improved. That's what we see on packages all the time. New, improved. This is a country founded in revolution. The planet Uranus right there in the first house. And the sign of Aquarius, the sign that the planet Uranus rules, every sign is ruled by a planet, folks, is right at the top of the chart. So again, here is a country that had to stir things up. And hey, Uranus is high tech. What country has always been the high tech leader? That's right, the United States. Now, again, folks, you always have to consider the entire horoscope. And there's been far too much emphasis placed on those so-called sun signs. So far, how many sun signs have we mentioned? None. Well, Bill Gates is a Scorpio. I did mention that. But you don't have to look at the sun sign to be able to tell a lot about the chart. My name is Bob Marks, and this is Astrology Now.